Back in December, I had some serious personal challenges. Those challenges caused me to be very depressed and also to abuse certain substances, particularly alcohol. And I had a crisis back in December that led me to the hospital. And upon release from the hospital, my doctor suggested that Skyland might be a good place for me to come and spend some time and do some more work, some more therapy. And so I came to Skyland and started learning some things, you know, learning DBT and other ways of coping with stress and coping with emotions and coping with life helped me to integrate a number of the things that now I'm working with and not feel like I'm sort of trapped in this dark room, you know, with no way to get out, which is how I felt for a long time prior to coming to Skyland.
When I was in the throes of my moments of depression, I didn't have confidence that I could do anything. I didn't think I could play the piano, I couldn't sing, I couldn't think critically, make decisions like a lawyer should be able to do. And it was all, of course, imaginary because I always had those abilities, I just wasn't able to utilize them at the time. I had had a few episodes of depression in my lifetime previously, and I had gotten treatment at several other facilities, and none of it had really been effective. But Skyland Trail's approach was different. This particular type of therapy got me to the point where I was focusing on just living for the moment and being present for the moment. And I really think that had a lot to do with my getting well, because now I don't worry about the future. My plan at this point is to return to the full-time practice of law. But this time around, I think I'm going to go at it a little bit differently. I'm interested in human rights. I'm interested in international law. And let me try to change and save the world that way.
I tried a lot of different coping skills to help me. They were negative, some of them, yes. I tried to help myself and self-medicate by using drugs, and then that didn't help. So I moved on to self-harming. I've been to a lot of therapists. I've been to a lot of psychiatrists. My life was miserable. I was living in hell every single day. Coming into Skyland Trail, I didn't trust anybody. I didn't know what a healthy relationship was. After a while of being at Skyland Trail, I started to have that hope again. I had the clients I could relate to. I had an amazing therapist. I had a psychiatrist that told me what I was diagnosed with, and I had no idea I was diagnosed with borderline personality disorder and PTSD. And it gave me hope when I started to understand DBT and when I started to apply it, and it was incredible how it worked and how it decreased my emotions. And I'm so grateful for Skyland Trail. They're my family. Skyland Trail is my family, and they will always be my family. I just have this brighter outlook on life, and I want to become a therapist, and I want to help others as they have helped me. And even though I'm working toward certain things, such as being a therapist, I'm just excited with the path that I'm on. People who don't believe that people with mental illness can get better, I'm proof. Age 10, I've been suffering with mental illness. And with hard work, dedication, and willingness, it is possible. It is very possible.
Life is so much better, so much more hopeful, so much more hopeful. I think that's the word, because prior to Skyland, I wasn't feeling hopeful at all. I was feeling like I didn't want to live, but now I do want to live. And so for individuals like myself that have issues with mental health, I think it's incumbent upon us to some degree to talk about that, to make it more visible, which is something I've tried to do. and to know that with treatment, we can live a very happy, productive life. And so that's what I try to do. And that's why I'm making this video, because it's important for me that individuals know that it's okay if you have challenges like this. Work with them, get the support that you need, try to be happy as best you can.